Hi, I'm Lourdes Martinez, and I'm going to present the results of my research focused on the movement patterns of hawksbill sea turtles in the Gulf of California, Mexico. Hawksbill turtles are one of the most threatened sea turtle species. They are listed as critically endangered by the IUCN Red List of Endangered Species and protected by the Convention on International Trade for Endangered Species. Conservation of these species and of sea turtles in general is difficult because they have vast distribution ranges, have a delayed sexual maturity, and they are exposed to a wide range of anthropogenic threats. The main driver of hawksbill populations' decline is the international shell trade, which has removed around 9 million individuals in a period of 150 years. In particular, the Eastern Pacific population, which includes the individuals that move between Mexico and Peru in the Pacific Ocean, is the most threatened hawksbill population and the one I'm studying. In Mexico, the Gulf of California is known as an important area for the species, but there is limited information on their movement patterns in this region. The Gulf is also the most important fishing region in the country, which puts hawksbills under high human pressure associated with coastal activities. For my research, I wanted to know if there were localized areas of long-term hawksbill presence, and if these localized areas were associated with particular habitats and spatial conservation strategies. To do it, from 2014 to 2019, I surveyed the coastal waters of the southwestern Gulf of California based on historical reports of the species and interviews with local fishermen. All captured turtles were tagged and measured to have individual records. And among all sites, I tagged 12 of the largest individuals with Argos Link GPS satellite transmitters. This transmitter provided me with high resolution locations of the individuals. With the locations information, I calculated home range areas to describe the space that hawksbills use based on their movements over time. By using the fixed kernel density estimation method, I generated the 95% and 50% utilization distribution maps for each turtle, which represented the overall home range area and the core areas of activity respectively for each individual. As main results, I captured 97 hawksbills that weigh between 4 to 68 kilograms. The majority of them were identified as juveniles, which highlights the relevance of the Gulf as a developmental area for the species. The home range analysis showed that hawksbills had highly restricted movements with concentrated areas of use for months and even years. As shown in the maps, the areas where they spent more than 50% of their time were smaller than 300 hectares and were associated with a variety of habitat types, including mangrove estuaries, coral reefs, and rocky reefs. In terms of spatial conservation strategies, only 10% of home range areas across all turtles fell within marine protected areas. But interestingly, 35% fell within no-take marine protected areas, which were established in collaboration with local fishing communities to recover commercially important species. So the main conclusion of my research is that hawksbills depend on particular coastal habitats for long periods of time. This brings hope to the recovery of the Eastern Pacific population because conservation funding can be allocated in those restricted areas. Also, I suggest that the expansion of the no-take marine protected areas within the Gulf of California is likely to result in additional win-win scenarios between sustainable fisheries management and hawksbill conservation. And this is the next step in my research. I want to thank the funders of this project and also the partners for the support during all the stages of my research. Thank you.